get ready to match the stars. Robert Hedges, Brett Summer, Charles Nelson Reilly, Ethel Merman, Richard Dawson, and Franny Flagg as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 76. And now, here's the star of Match Game 76, Gene Rammer.
Johnny Olson and friends.
Sharp as a, look at the lining.
A double-breasted vescot.
Oh, sharp as a tack.
So, as long as I'm all dressed up, I might as well go to work, huh? Right.
Why not?
Okay, let's say hello to our two players, Patty Bradford and Jaretta Worden. Ladies. Now, Patty here is our current champ. She has $1,200 to her credit, and she's very happy about that. She lives in the area of, or works in Washington, D.C., and lives around there somewhere.
Alexandria.
In Alexandria, across the river there, and you work for a congressman?
Right.
Okay. And she's being challenged here by Jaretta. We're in the middle of round two, and if these look blank, it's not because the electricity was shut off because we didn't pay the bill. It's they are blank. She's drawn a blank on both of her questions.
Thank you.
Now, yesterday you were very nervous and tense. Are you looser today?
Yeah, I took tranquilizer.
Did you really? Well, you carry him around with you. Are you always nervous?
No.
Poor girl. I see you've got a... Is that a good luck symbol there?
Dorsan, Miss Pennsylvania that I met backstage.
Yeah?
She said, I did so lousy. She said, this is for you to have good luck. So she gave me a $2 bill.
To bring you good luck, eh?
Yeah.
Well, I'll just take that from you. It hasn't done
I'm
any
doing
good
just...
so far. Just stick it in there, and you'll have better luck without it. Now, we'll start
the finish this game in a moment or so, but right now, this message for you.
All right, here we go. Whoops. Wait a minute now. Don't nobody move, and don't stop the tape or do anything insane like that. I'll just fix this. It'll just take a second here. There it is. Oh, there you are. Whoops. Well, that wasn't supposed to happen. Well, what the heck with that? All right. Are you ready?
Yeah.
I'm not. And the machine ain't either. When the satellite pictures came back from Mars, the scientist said, I think that Martian knows we're taking his picture. Look, he's blanking. What about that now?
What did you say?
When the satellite pictures came back from Mars, the scientist said, I think that Martian knows we're taking his picture. Look, he's blanking. You understand? Satellite pictures, you know, satellite went up to Mars.
Yeah.
And it took pictures, an automatic camera there. One scientist who was watching the TV monitor back at Space Central in Houston, Texas, he said to the other scientist, I think that Martian knows we're taking his picture. Look, he's blanking.
That question should come out in hardcover. It's such a long story.
Yes, it is. But everybody understands?
Yes, teacher.
Quickly. Okay, Patty Bradford. When the satellite pictures came back from Mars, the scientist said, I think that Martian knows we're taking his picture. Look, he's blanking.
He's smiling.
Smiling. All right, one smile will win another game. She said he's smiling. What do you say, Juan Epstein?
I tried to keep it as astrological as possible. I said he was mooning.
He was mooning?
Mooning, yes.
Throwing a moon, eh? Haven't seen one of those in...
Since last night.
Show the card.
Well, I figured he was cranky because we were up there, so he was flashing.
Oh, really? Hey, wear raincoats on Mars, eh?
Woo!
Okay, Charles.
I said, and you can flash in a Mackinac for that matter.
That's true.
I said saying cheese.
Saying cheese. Cheese.
Isn't that smiling?
Patty, well, no, but it gives the effect, but it's different. Her answer is smiling, and that's what we were looking for. Look, he's smiling. What do you say?
Well, I said he wanted to look good. He was laughing.
Cheers. Laughing. Oh, so close, Patty. And yet so far, maybe Richard will give you a smile.
Well, you're smiling.
Ah, you're smiling.
When you're smiling.
The sun comes shining through.
I'll just hang around there for a minute. Well, Jaretta, I did give her $2.
$2.
No, I don't want no bad luck $2 bill. You hang on to that, honey. And I hope you have a pleasant trip back to wherever you're going. And you're a sweet, dear lady, and life is going to be good to you. And we've got That's gifts for you. Jaretta Ward. Goodbye.
Here it is again, Patty.
Well,
all yours.
He's just picked up another 100, and you could win over 5,000 here. Shall we begin?
Yes.
Stand on the tape. Okay. We polled a recent studio audience, Patty, and we got their best response to this. Ultra blank. Now, the answer they gave most frequently is worth $500 if you match it. If you match the next one, you get $250, then the third one gets you $100. And three of our celebrities are permitted to assist by suggesting answers.
Richard, please.
Ultraviolet.
Ultraviolet, one.
Danny.
Danny.
Ultra chic.
Ultra chic.
Brett, please.
And Brett?
Am I number three?
You are number three.
I didn't
but there's
okay.
still one good
number
one,
two.
Brett.
Ultra bright.
That's okay. Ultra bright, ultraviolet, ultra chic are the three, Patty.
Ultra bright.
You want ultra bright? Okay. Ultra bright, you say no? Some say no and some say yes. Well, we're going the moment of truth is at hand now. Let's begin by revealing the lower number there. Earl, would you please slide the $100 response? Ultra sheen.
That's what I said.
No, you said ultra chic.
Oh, I'm
Martin Sheen's brother.
Yes. We are looking for ultra bright. May we see the $250 response? Ultra bright. Patty, you got it. Congratulations. There's $250 more for you. You now have $1,550. And those of you in the audience who disagreed with her, what do you say it is?
Violet!
Violet. Sweet Violet. May we see it, please? You're right! You're right.
Trust me.
He is rarely wrong in this game. Okay, so you can play for 10 times $250 or $2,500. Now, who do you want?
Richard. I've been with them twice. The third time's a charm.
Okay. All right.
This time I'm going to take you out.
Here we go. Ready? This is worth $2,500. Goes like this. Plum blank. Plum blank. Now, Patty, what answer do you want to give us? What you think will match his? Get your ESP going and your Richard Dawson thought waves. What do you say?
Pudding.
You say pudding? You don't want to say plum dumpling? Why not?
Never heard of it.
You never heard of plum dumplings?
No.
Oh, they're marvelous. I make them myself all the time. She says plum pudding will match you. No?
We just don't seem to be doing it right. Have some pudding.
Oh,
all right. I found my true love.
Bouncing around. We've got a little message for you here, friends. Come back and find out how it all ends. Okay. We're ready to carry on. To do so, we're very pleased to present a new player. Let's welcome Bernie Diamond. Hello, Bernie. Nice to have you with us.
Thank you, Jim. Nice to be here.
Good. Where are you from, Bernie?
I'm from Ogden, Utah, the home of the Howard Hughes Will Manufacturing Service. There's a very funny story about that, but it's a Utah story. I've been married for 36 wonderful years, have 3 married children and 10 grandchildren.
No kidding.
Yes, sir.
Oh, boy. All right. You vacationing around here?
Pardon, sir?
You vacationing in our area
Been vacationing here? For the past week at Laguna Beach and ready to head back unless I stay here forever.
Okay. Well, good luck to Bernie Diamond. Let's begin by asking him to make a selection, A or B.
B, please, James.
Okay. We're off and running. You got B for Bernie. Judy said, I have the dreaded peach pit disease. She said, whenever I eat peaches, pits grow from my blank. Dreaded peach pit. It sounds like an Orson Bean joke,
Say
doesn't it?
Say that fast.
I have the dreaded peach pit disease. Whenever I eat peaches, pits grow from my blank.
Gee whizzakers.
Oh.
Pits grow.
Now remember, you're in show business, all of you, including Bernie.
Bernie has eyes bluer than Jack Benny's.
Yes, and he has very beautiful
eyes.
Blue eyes. Okay, everybody ready in the lower tier?
Yeah.
What about you, Juan Epstein? You ready?
You got it.
Okay. Now, we'll come over here to Bernie. Judy said I have the dreaded peach pit disease. Whenever I eat peaches, pits grow from my...
bottom pit. Or bottom, as the case may be.
I see.
No.
This is the most hazardous thing. I don't even get hazard pay for doing this show. What do you say?
What did the good man say again?
He said bottom.
Bottom.
Yeah, well, you know, the pit, the cave, a hole in the ground is a pit, and it's, I don't know what. Go ahead.
Underarms.
Underarms. Arms.
Underarms.
Armpits, Bernie.
Oh, armpits.
Armpits, you see.
It's a sight gag.
Yes, right. Go ahead, Brett.
I wish to state in front that I'm not too crazy about that little funky question. There's no excuse for my answer, but I mean, I'm just saying. I said from my nose.
Okay. First round questions can be trying. This is a trying one.
Armpits.
Armpits. Well, that seems to be the definitive answer, Bernie.
Yeah,
armpits, yes. Miss Merman, honey.
Well, I don't know if you swallow them, they grow from your stomach.
Oh, they do? Oh, right, yes. If you swallow them, yeah, sure. Okay, that's one thing, but... see, they were going for a little joke there. Peach pits, armpits, you see. That's enough of that. Okay.
I won't go for those jokes.
You won't?
Don't like them.
I see. I don't blame you. Don't like the question either, do you?
Nope.
No.
Navel.
Navel, yeah. Sprinkle a little water on it, fertilizers. Let's put a little lime there. What do you say, Fanny?
I say let you and I go over to Tattletales. I say ears.
Ears.
I don't know why.
Okay. So, Bernie, that's the way it is in the first round questions. They're tough, aren't they, Patty?
Mm-hmm.
All right, here's one for you. Ralph said, when I was a kid in the slums, we were too poor to afford a dog, but I made do. I taught the blanks to fetch. As a kid, I worked in a slum. I lived in the slums. We were poor, too poor to afford a dog, but I made do. I taught the blanks to fetch. That's it. You know anything about the slums?
No.
No.
Me.
No.
No, just a country boy from Jersey.
I see. All right.
Oh, wait a minute. I'm missing one letter.
Okay, put it in a slot there. Patty Bradford, Ralph said, when I was a kid in the slums, we were too poor to afford a dog, but I made do. I taught the blanks to fetch.
Rats.
Rats is good. Well, she came up with the answer. What do you say?
Yes, rats to you, Patty.
Rats it is. Rats or roaches would be the two good ones. What have you got? Have you got one of those?
Well, what about those friendly little roaches?
Roaches would be very good, yes. Charles?
Thank you, sweetheart.
Do you know every day you say roaches? When the answer should be rats, mice, kangaroos, caterpillars, you always say roaches.
Two for Patty. Ethel?
Has to
looking
be
for
rats.
A rat. Rats. She's sure. Looking for a rat. She found one.
You know that rats backwards is star?
It is. I didn't
know that. You dirty rat.
Yes. Now, Fanny.
I'm sorry. You know how you're affected in your private life? I just came from dinner at Brett's house. I said roaches.
Oh, yeah. Well, there you are. You got four. That's in round one. 4-0. Score round two coming up a little bit, but right now this. Okay. Are you ready to carry on? We'll go to round two. Shall we do that? Okay. Now, Bernie, it's your choice.
I'm going to be again.
Be again?
Yes, sir.
All right. He's consistent. B for Bernie. Tinkerbell said, Captain Hook is wonderful. Yesterday, he blanked my ears. Captain Hook is wonderful. Yesterday, he blanked my ears.
I've been crazy about all week.
Captain Hook. Remember Captain Hook? He had a steel question mark at the end of his wrist there. Okay, put it in the slot, and away we go. Now, Bernie, here it is. Tinkerbell said Captain Hook is wonderful. Yesterday, he blanked my ears.
Pierced.
Very good!
Mm-hmm.
By Jove, he came up with a definitive answer.
Yes, and not so fortunate here.
Really?
He kissed my ears.
Oh.
I couldn't get blow in there. I couldn't get ED.
No, but pierced my ears is the perfect answer with the hook, you see? The ears, you've got a pointy hook there. Oh, I'm going to put you back another grade.
Yes.
What do you say?
I'd like to be able to pick on Robert, but I can't.
But you got one just as bad.
I said he picked my ear, you know, with this
little
hook.
Oh, yeah, okay, all right. Two rotten ones. Now I gotta match everybody else here who's remaining, Bernie, to stay in the game. Charles.
Hmm. Pierced.
Well, Bernie, at least somebody understands you. What do you say, Ethel?
They didn't have any Q-tips, so he took his hook and he cleaned his ears.
He's cleaned his ears, so that means Patty wins the game. Okay. Oh, boy. Well, Bernie.
It was a pleasure, Gene.
It was a pleasure meeting you, sir. We're going to send you a lot of gifts. Maybe three. So long, Bernie Diamond. You're a terrific guy. There it is again, Patty. Fourth time up here. You just picked up another $100. You got $4,150. You're going to play for over $5,000. Let's begin by pointing out to you that we polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Blank. Range. R-A-N-G-E.
No R on the end of it.
No, R-A-N-G-E is all it is.
We can't see over
blank here. Range. Now, remember, if you match the answer that bunch of people gave most frequently, you get $500. $250 for the middle one and $100 for the bottom one. Who do you call on me?
Richard.
Give me a home in the Buffalo room. Home on the range.
Home on the range.
Fanny, please. Now,
oven range.
My answers.
No, it was.
Oven
range.
Kitchen
range? Kitchen, no, oven range is what we have to go with.
And Brett.
What about firing range?
Firing range, okay. That's a military phrase. Firing range, oven range, and home on the range. Now, have you been thinking about it?
Home on the range.
You want that one? Home on the range. Well, let's find out if it's up there. I have no idea. We'll begin down at the bottom and reveal the $100 response. Long range.
Always in plans.
Yes, long range plans.
Yeah. Long range.
Long range mission there. We're looking for home on the range. Here's a $250 number. Rifle range was firing range. That might have matched. I don't know. All right, last chance for home on the range. Here is the $500 response. Home on the range. You got it again. Oh. Very good. Congratulations. Now, you got $4,650. $4,650. A little quicker there on the scoreboard, if you would, please. I had to have that in my head, and, you know, I can't add. Okay. Now you're going to play for 10 times 500 or $5,000. To collect that, you got to match one ding-a-ling exactly.
Richard.
Okay. Swing around over here. That's it.
I gave her oven.
Yeah.
I don't know why she didn't do that.
Me.
Here it is. Get your ESP going over to him. Send out electrical waves there to him. Blank Sunday. Blank Sunday. S-U-N-D-A-Y. Sunday.
S-U-N-D-A-Y.
S-U-N-D-A-Y. Sunday. Now, Patty, he's finished. We need your answer. One you think will match his. What do you say to that? Blank Sunday.
Never on Sunday.
Never on Sunday? Really? Is that the way it is?
Okay. Saturday, yes. Sunday, no.
Okay, she says never on Sunday. We'll match you.
The only day I have off. Just my luck.
What did you say, Richard?
Well, there were a lot. There were Black Sunday.
Black Sunday?
I said Easter Sunday.
Easter Sunday. That's a good one. What else is there, John? Mostly
Bloody
Easter
Sunday.
Sunday. How about Chocolate Sunday?
Palm Sunday.
Palm Sunday. Yes. Well, there are a lot of good ones. Okay.
Chocolate.
Now, Patty, you've got $4,650, and you'll meet another player later. But right now, we want you to watch this. Now, here we go. It's all over.
I guess
Aren't
it
you
is.
Glad
yes,
you came?
Yes,
they
yes.
Had a good time, did
what
you?
A marvelous
Come back
time.
Next time.
I
tomorrow.
Sure
tomorrow.
Will.
Okay.
Yes, my darling.
And you, we'll look forward to seeing you and welcome back Carter.
You bet.
Juan Epstein, how does he talk? What does he say?
Epstein, he's a pretty good guy. You know,
Epstein
he talks like
is a
this.
Pretty good guy. He talks like that.
He's a pretty good guy.
He's a pretty good guy, yes.
Yeah.
All right.
How do you say goodbye?
Dovigenia.
Hurry.